Hello everyone, I'm Ji Yoon Boo. I'm a graduate student of Nanocell Treating Systems Laboratory in Bio and Brain Engineering Department. Today's lecture will be about the metabolism of cancer cell. I will briefly introduce you about the topic, and details will be dealt by Professor Soo-Yeol Kim. Contents are as follows. First, I'll talk about why and how the metabolism of cancer cell is different from normal cell. Then, I will shortly give you how this specific characteristic can be used in biopharmaceuticals. The metabolism of cancer cell is reprogrammed both by oncogene signaling and by dysregulation of metabolic enzymes. It has been proved that oncogenes are frequently altered in various cancers. A substantial proportion of oncogenic abnormality is associated with growth signaling pathway. Recently, increasing evidence has suggested that growth signaling pathways directly control cell metabolism through the regulation of metabolic enzymes. In addition, individual metabolic enzymes have been reported to be mutated or amplified during tumor progressions. The resulting altered metabolism supports cellular proliferation and the survival, but leaves cancer cells dependent on a continuous supply of nutrients. Therefore, sufficient nutrients needed to be supplied for proliferating tumor. Difference in metabolism for differentiated and proliferative tissues, for example tumor, are well illustrated in the left figure. In the presence of oxygen, non-proliferating tissues first metabolize glucose to pyruvate via glycolysis and then completely oxidize most of pyruvate in the mitochondria to CO2 during the process of oxidative phosphorylation. In this process, 36 mol ATP are produced for 1 mol of glucose. When oxygen is limiting, cells can redirect the pyruvate generated by glycolysis away from mitochondria by generating lactate. This generation of lactate allows glycolysis to continue but results in minimal ATP production when compared with oxidative phosphorylation. However, for tumor, cancer cells tend to convert most of glucose to lactate, no matter how much oxygen is available. This process is called aerobic glycolysis or Warburg effect. In this process, only about 10% of ATP is generated compared to oxidative phosphorylation. So initially, it was considered that abnormality in mitochondria was the reason for cancer. However, it was proven that mitochondria remained functional by finding out that some of oxidative phosphorylation still continues in tumor. In summary, aerobic glycolysis is less efficient than oxidative phosphorylation for generating ATP. Then why a less efficient metabolism would be selected for in proliferating cells? There are two reasons. First, inefficient ATP production is a problem only when resources are limited. This is not the case for proliferating mammalian cells, which are exposed to a continual supply of glucose and other nutrients in circulating blood. Also for tumor, capillaries are distended and by angiogenesis, more nutrients are provided. Another reason is that during growth, glucose is used to generate biomass as well as ATP. During the synthesis of amino acids, nucleotides, or other cellular components, not only ATP, but also carbon and NADPH are consumed. Therefore, glycolysis, oxidative phosphorylation, pentose phosphate pathway, and glutamine metabolism are all interconnected in synthesis of biomass. Figure below shows the relationship between these processes when new biomass is produced. However, even among tumors arising from the same tissue, they exhibit heterogeneous metabolic alterations that extend beyond the Warburg effect. Various uptakes of biomolecules and variable secretion of lactate are all observed in cancers in the same tissue. This metabolic heterogeneity occurs because of various reasons. Some of the metabolic heterogeneity is influenced by the tumor microenvironment. Abnormal tumor vasculature can result in gradient of nutrients, oxygen, and pH. In addition, the signaling mechanisms of cells are linked to growth control pathways that sense nutrient conditions. Therefore, these signaling mechanisms also influence metabolism. Also, genetic alterations that are associated with cancer often occur in these signaling pathways and influence metabolic heterogeneity. However, how pathways are regulated to facilitate cell proliferation is not perfectly known. But by understanding tumor cell metabolism, selectively targeting the biosynthetic process of cancer cell might be possible. Then why target cancer cell metabolism? There are three reasons. First, metabolism may influence cancer initiation and progression. Second, targeting metabolism could improve existing approaches. Finally, metabolism is a proven target of successful therapies. For example, antifolate drugs were developed before there was an understanding of how folic acids contribute to a metabolic cycle that allows single carbon transfer reactions, which are critical for the generation of nucleic acid. This is well described in below figure. There are some key issues when targeting cancer cell metabolism. And there are challenges of directly targeting metabolic pathways because all cells rely on the same metabolic pathways to generate ATP. Also, metabolic flux in cancer cell is not well understood. However, recent advances in metabolic profiling methodologies are providing new tools for understanding flux through pathways. In addition, genetic events define an ideal set of possible targets for cancer therapy. But unfortunately, many of the gene products are transcription factors or signaling molecules that rely on protein-to-protein interaction and present challenges to drug development. For targeting cancer cell metabolisms, such compounds have the potential to limit macromolecular synthesis needed for cell growth. Alternatively, there are compounds that can limit pathways that are important for supplying nutrients to the cell and impair bioenergetics. Therefore, approaches for targeting cancer cell metabolism include these five in black boxes. These tables show strategies to target metabolic enzymes for cancer therapy. In conclusion, genetic events in cancer activate signaling pathways. Clinical evidence has linked cell metabolism with cancer outcomes. Together, these observations have raised interest in targeting metabolic enzymes for cancer therapy, but they have also raised concerns that these therapies would have unacceptable effects on normal cells. Thank you for listening. I hope you have a good time with Professor Suyeol Kim. Thank you.